Hi, my name is Chris Wysopal. I'm the CTO and co-founder for Veracode, and I'm here today to share with you five essential steps for shifting security left. Step four, create security champions. When I talk about security champions, what I mean is someone who is on the development team, someone who's part of a scrum team, so their day job is designing code, writing code, testing code, and we want to make them a security champion. We want to make them the expert for their scrum team on application security. When we can embed a security champion into every scrum team, we're guaranteed that there's some security knowledge that's part of every design decision, every stand-up when the team is discussing building their software. This is a way that the centralized or AppSec experts you might have at the company don't have to be everywhere at one time and don't become a bottleneck. The security champions can work together as a team to make sure the application is built with security in mind. Within the company, you often think of the CISO as the one that's responsible for making sure the company is secure. But that's outdated thinking. The CISO can't be everywhere. There's too much going on within a company, especially when you talk about a company building applications. Really, the developers and the development team need to be responsible for building secure software. And the CISO's office ends up giving them the tools and the process and governance, but ultimately, the development team is responsible for finding and fixing the flaws so that they can deliver secure software. One of the things we do here at Veracode is we get together with all of our security champions and our security experts. They can get together, they can discuss security issues in the news, they can work together to build a community. And you really need to have that security community embedded within the development organizations if you want to build secure software. My best advice for creating a culture of security is to make sure it's starting at the top down. The development organization, for example, needs to have their engineering management and leadership bought in that security is important and it's something that they want to see a community built around. The second part of this is getting the security team to interact with the development team and building up a set of security champions that builds a community where people care about security within the development organization. Some of the things we do at Veracode is we get all the security champions together with the security team to do capture the flags exercises, attacking a piece of software so they can understand it from the hacker's perspective, discussing current malware and worm attacks that are going on in the news to get the security perspective from the experts onto the developers. So they get a real world understanding of the vulnerabilities they could be creating in the code and they start to care about building secure software. That gives them ownership of building a secure application in the end.